Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Anandita, Arvind, Tasneem, Kavya, and Mirza Sania. I hope everyone is doing the study very well, and today we are starting a new chapter, that is biotechnology and its application. So this is the first session of this chapter. Hello CR Lakshmi, I hope your study must be going on very well. Biology, chemistry and physics, you must be having a good revision at home. So starting this new chapter, this is the overview of the chapter. What are the subtopics and the topics which we are covering in this session, not only in this session, in coming sessions also. So we are starting this chapter with the introduction, how the biotechnology is useful and the applications of biotechnology, biotechnological applications in agriculture. Most importantly, discussing about the genetically modified organism like GMOs, BT cotton. Most of the question comes from this section. Also, some other transgenic plants. And after that, we will be covering RNA interference, one of the most important, also one of important topic from this chapter, that is RNA interference technique, which is present in all eukaryotic cells. Then there is biotechnological applications in medicine. So in medicine, we know about the genetically engineered insulin. How a pro-insulin molecule changes into a insulin molecule. Most importantly, the diagrammatic view of the insulin and gene therapy. Molecular diagnosis, how the molecular diagnosis or the early detection of the diseases can be done by the help of molecular diagnosis. Then transgenic animals, why are these animals being produced, and some ethical issues related with biotechnology and its application. So all these topics we will be covering in this chapter. Today I am discussing about the introductory part, GMOs and the BT cotton, and some other small topics are also there. So hello Manish, Shivani and Sri Hari Murthy. We have gone through the entire process of biotechnology, like rDNA technology, recombinant DNA technology, how we can make a recombinant molecule, and we are now inserting that recombinant molecule into a particular host cell, either plant, animals or microorganism. Then we are getting our desired product in the form of a protein. So many useful recombinant proteins, we have already talked about this. And by means of the bioreactors, we are making that protein at a larger scale in industry. Then after that, there is down processing of the protein. So in this chapter, we are dealing with like how the biotechnology is very useful. What is the use of transgenic plant and animals? How they are useful to us? So various application of biotechnology we are going to discuss here. Biotechnology essentially deal with industrial scale production of biopharmaceuticals. Like what I said, bioreactor. By means of bioreactor, we are producing a number of recombinant proteins. These are useful in treatment of diseases, therapeutics, biologicals using genetically modified microorganisms, fungi, plant and animals. And when the alteration is done in the genome of the microbes, fungi, plant and animals, they are known as GMOs, genetically modified organisms. So the application of biotechnology, what it includes? It includes therapeutics, treatment of any disease or a therapy or about a drug, its diagnostic, genetically modified crop for agriculture. So many genetically modified crops are now available. Processed food, bioremediation, treatment of like pollutants with the help of microorganism, waste treatment and energy production. So these are the different fields in which the biotechnology has been used and it is very beneficial. So there are most importantly three critical research areas of biotechnology. What are these research areas? Providing the best catalyst which help in any reaction. Biological catalyst are the enzymes. Yes, in a chemical reactions, these are the catalyst. In biological living system, these are the enzymes. And in the form of improved organism, usually a microbe or pure enzyme. So providing the best catalyst which assist in any biological process in the form of improved organisms, and this organism can be a microbes or a pure enzymes. So enzymes are what? Proteins. Yes. Now creating second one research area for biotechnology is creating optimal condition through engineering for a catalyst to act. What are these optimal conditions through engineering for a catalyst to act? So providing all the necessary optimum conditions for a protein or a enzyme to work through engineering, that is the second research area. Optimal conditions like the providing a sterile ambience, okay, providing proper temperature, pH and all other requirements which are necessary for a catalyst to give its 100% result. Biostream processing technologies. So third one is the downstream processing technologies, like we have made a protein at a larger scale in industry. So after that it's isolation, purification, separation and then it's testing, trials, all these processes in downstream processing technologies to purify the protein or the organic compound. So whatever we have made by means of biotechnology, for we have to check for the downstream processing also. So these are the three critical research areas of biotechnology: providing the best catalyst in the form of improved organism, that can be usually it is a microbe or pure enzyme, creating optimal conditions through engineering for a catalyst to act, downstream processing technologies to purify the protein or organic compound. Okay. So first of all, we are discussing about or we are learning about biotechnological application in agriculture. So if you see the traditional method, what are these traditional methods? These are selection, hybridization, protoplast fusion, like fusion of the protoplast of the plants. What these involve? There is the involvement of the whole genome. The whole genome, we are treating the whole genome in these crop improvement methods. And these traditional methods, these include selection, hybridization, protoplast fusion. And in this traditional method, we are just involving the whole of the genome. And this involvement of the whole genome and this traditional method of crop improvement, these are time consuming. What are the drawbacks of these methods? First of all, these are time consuming. And second thing is that not necessary what we were expecting is the result. The result can vary from our expectations. So results are not always satisfactory. So how were the latest biotechnological methods? What was in rDNA technology? We were inserting our gene of interest not the whole fragment we were taking, not the whole genome we were taking from the plant. We were just taking the part of the genome in which our coding sequence is present, which code for a particular protein. So, how this biotechnological method is ahead of these traditional method? So, these involve transfer of one or more than one beneficial gene. That gene is beneficial in many ways from one plant to another plant. That is what we are doing in these latest methods. The following agriculture approaches are generally considered for increasing the food production. There are three agriculture based approaches which are generally considered for increasing the food production. If we are doing, we are using biotechnology, or we are making, we are inserting any beneficial gene from one part to another, one plant to another plant. So what is our motive? Our motive is to get good crop or good food production. So there are three means by which we can increase our food production. And what are these three means? Three means, these are the agriculture based on use of agrochemicals. Like, it involves the use of agrochemicals such as pesticides, herbicides, the chemicals, synthetic fertilizers in agriculture to improve the crop yield. Now it is very much use of fertilizers and use of agrochemicals such as pesticides and herbicides. But there are some drawbacks also. Using the herbicide, it not only removes the weeds, the herb which are present, it also result in loss of the crop. Second is the agriculture based on use of organic or biofertilizer. Now, as the chemical fertilizers are not so good, so there is another way, organic farming or the bio use of biofertilizers. It is an environmental friendly method that involves the use of manure, compost, organic or biofertilizers in agriculture to increase the crop yield. Another method which is used in spite of using these synthetic fertilizers, there is another approach, and in this approach the farmers are using biofertilizers, or it is known as organic farming, because the manures is used there, or the organic or the biofertilizers is in use. So this is the second approach. The third approach is the use of genetically engineered crop, or it involves the use of modern biotechnological methods to meet challenges in agriculture production by employing recombinant DNA technology. Means, beneficial gene we are inserting into a plant from another plant, and this beneficial gene can be beneficial in terms of enhanced nutritional value. It has disease resistance, like BT cotton. Yes, BT cotton, it is a genetically modified cotton plant which have resistance against various pests. So these are the genetically engineered crop, and in these genetically engineered crop, what scientists are using in lab, they are just inserting a beneficial gene. They are taking a gene from a plant which has enhanced nutritional value, which is disease resistant, and inserting into the another plant. That is how this is the third approach, agriculture based on genetically engineered crop. Okay, so here comes the genetically modified organism. Plants, bacteria, fungi and animal whose genes have been altered. The alteration in the genome of the organisms, they are known as genetically modified organisms or transgenic organisms. Okay, is this clear? Till now, is this clear? What are transgene and what are genetically modified organisms? We are going in detail in minutes. Till now, the approaches which are used in agriculture, I have discussed that only, and how the agriculture is beneficial, we are going to discuss about various examples now, one by one. So by this diagram, what you can see the layout of the making of a transgenic plant. Like these are the desired gene which we need either to improve the nutritional value, either to have a resistance against any disease or having a resistance against any pest. So what we are doing by this, we are just making a rDNA molecule. Yes, as we have discussed rDNA technology in detail in previous chapter, so whole detail I am not going here. The desired gene has been inserted into the genome and we have created a rDNA, recombinant DNA. Now incorporation into a host cell, and as you can see there is multiplication and there is formation of a transgenic plant. So what is transgenic plant? It has the gene from another plant which have some good value. So this is the ray diagram by which you can understand the process of how the genetically modified organisms can be created. Okay, is this clear? Is this clear, guys? Everyone, Shri Vatsan, Shri Harimurti, Shivani, Manish, Tashneem, CR Lakshmi, Mirza Sania, Kavya, Arvind and Anandita. I'm asking to everyone, the three approaches, these are clear, guys? So why these genetically modified organisms are beneficial? These have some very good qualities, like the crop which we are making, it is more tolerant to abiotic stress like the abiotic factors, cold, drought, salt and heat. So the crop which we are making is more tolerant to all these factors, because all these factors has the adverse effect on the cultivation of a crop. If the right temperature is not there, if the drought is there, if the flood is there, heat and salt, the amount of minerals in the soil. So genetically modified organisms have all the essential things which can enhance the productivity of a crop, which has the better nutritional values, which have the genes against a particular disease. That's why we are making a transgenic plant. That's why we are creating any genetically modified organism, because we want to have all the good qualities so that that plant sustain for longer time, that plant gives her better nutritional values, that have all the better nutrients, that have the productivity. In terms of productivity, it should be better. It should be like pest resistant. That is very much, because most of the crop, when at the time of harvesting, most of the crop is damaged because of the various kind of pest. So it should have resistance against pest. So what scientists are doing, they are just inserting the gene which has some kind of resistance against a particular pest, or they are just making any protein. The gene is encoding for a protein which is toxic for any pest. If the pest is infecting any plant or digest the leaves, like the leaves of the plant, it is going to die. So this is how the genetically modified organisms are beneficial. Right now we are talking about the plants. So made crops more tolerant to abiotic stresses like cold, drought, salt or heat. Reduce reliance on chemical pesticides. So if we are inserting any gene which is giving resistance against any particular pest, then we don't need any chemical pesticide. Then so there is less dependency on the chemical pesticides. Help to reduce post-harvest losses. So as it is, the plant is already of the good quality, it can sustain better, it can sustain drought, it can sustain cold, it can sustain the high temperature or the heat. So the post-harvest losses are less automatically, it is directly proportional. increased efficiency of mineral uses by plant to prevent early exhaustion of fertility of the soil. So it also increases efficiency of mineral uses by plant so that it prevent the early exhaustion of the fertility of the soil. Not only one type of mineral is used by the plant. If only one type of mineral like the nitrogen is used up, all the nitrogen is used up by the plant, then the soil losses its fertility. So it increases the efficiency of the mineral uses, various kind of mineral uses by the plant. And one of the most commonly asked question from this, golden rice, enhanced nutritional value of food. Example is very, very important. That is, many time question has been asked the same question, vitamin D, in generally in case of like match the column. So golden rice have a gene which is vitamin A enriched, and beta carotene. So this increases the nutritional value of food. Okay, I am discussing this in minutes also in detail. So vitamin A, you have to remember this, golden rice is enriched with this. These are the genetically made rice, type of rice, which are enriched in vitamin A, beta carotene. Genetically modified crop or transgenic crop are prepared by transferring genes from one plant to another plant. We have discussed already. So such genes are called transgene, which are transferred, and the plant in which foreign genes are introduced are known as transgenic crop. So the crop which is prepared by means of rDNA technology, like insertion of this particular gene, isolating this gene and inserting into the genome of the host cell, then their production, the type of crop which we are getting by means of biotechnological application, or the type of crop in which any foreign gene are introduced, are known as transgenic crops. Okay, and the genes are known as transgene. This is asked also, herbicide tolerance. What are herbicides? Herbicides are the chemicals which kill the weeds. So weeds are what? These are a type of herbs, and these are the unwanted plants or the herbs which grows along with the crop. And when this grows along with the crop, they are competing for the nutrients which are present in the soil. They are competing for the water which is present in the soil. And so these are harmful to the growing crop. So the herbicides, which are the chemicals, when they sprayed in the field, when we are spraying the chemicals or the herbicide to destroy these weeds, so not only the weeds kill, these also damage the crop plant. So by means of biotechnological techniques, by means of these techniques, transgenic crop plants are developed which are resistant to herbicides and not damaged on exposure of herbicides. So in transgenic crop plant, what scientists are doing, they are developed which are resistant to herbicides. They are giving resistant to herbicides so that along with the weeds, there should be no damage to the crop plant, no damage to the crop plants. Okay, so some herbicide resistant crop produced by genetic engineering: tomato, potato, tobacco, soybean, cotton, corn, oilseed, rape, and sugar beet, petunia. So you have to remember all these examples as it is, because the question will be like, which of the following is not a transgenic crop? So you will be given like tomato, soya bean, cucumber and petunia. So the right answer from these will be which is not a transgenic. So you have to write cucumber. Okay, so the herbicide resistant crops produced by transgenic engineering, so what they are providing, why they are beneficial? Because they have the herbicide resistance, so that only it has herbicides effect should be on the weeds, it should not be on the growing crop. So how this herbicide tolerance in plants can be achieved? Either there should be the overproduction of those enzymes which are inactivated by herbicides. If there will be the overproduction of the enzymes which are inactivated by means of herbicide, then there will be herbicide tolerance. Inducing mutation resulting in the production of enzymes which are less sensitive to the herbicides. Now, artificially inducing mutation which result in the production of the enzymes in the crops which are less sensitive to the herbicide. Third is the introduction of such enzyme which cause detoxification of herbicides. Now, several enzymes, there are three means by which herbicide tolerance in these plants can be achieved. Several such enzymes has been identified already in plant as well as in microbes, and these are transferred into crop plant to produce transgenic plant resistant to herbicides. So most important topic for today, that is the BT cotton. Biotechnological techniques improve crop yield by the following ways. One of the means is the giving the pest resistance, having a gene which provide the resistance against pest. BT cotton, the first genetically modified crop of the country. What is BT cotton? BT cotton is the first genetically modified crop. And in this BT cotton, it is a pest resistant plant. It gives resistance against the pest and the particularly Lepidopterans insect, which causes bollworm disease cotton. Now, not only BT cotton is available, BT corn is available, rice, tomato, potato and soya bean is also available. So all these have the resistance against a particular kind of pest, because pests are very harmful. They just spoil the whole crop. So there should be any particular gene which provide the resistance against this pest. So BT cotton is the first genetically modified crop of the country, and in this a particular gene is inserted which is providing resistance against pest. Okay, so here in this diagram, this is the first diagram and this is the second diagram. What we are seeing the cotyl ball destroyed by bollworms. Here are the cotyl balls. Okay, so these are destroyed by bollworms. There are two terms, cotton bollworm and cotton corn borer. And especially these are Lepidopterans. These are what? These are the moths, caterpillar pest. And this is a fully mature cotton ball. So you can see how this is spoiled by means of the bollworms. So in leps, a gene is inserted from a bacterium, which is isolated from a bacterium, into the cotton plant, which is having the resistance against this pest. So whenever the pest come and digest the part of the crop, then they are going to die. BT cotton. BT is here for Bacillus thuringiensis. They produce proteins that kill certain insect, and these insect are Lepidopterans, Coleopterans, Diopterans. Learn this as it is. Learn this as it is. What I am saying. टोबैको बडवॉर्म, आर्मी वॉर्म, बीटल्स, फ्लाइज एंड मॉस्किटोज. सो यू विल हैव इन एग्जामिनेशन, वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन, लाइक मैच द कॉलम्स विद दिस, लाइक दिस. इट विल बी गिवन इन ए सेकेंड एंड थर्ड, ए बी एंड सी. ओके, सो लेपिडोप्टेरेंस विल बी हियर, डायप्टेरेंस विल बी हियर, कॉलियोप्टेरेंस विल बी हियर. सो हाउ यू कैन रिमेंबर दिस, दीज आर द टेरेंस, लेपिडो, कॉलियो, डायप्टेरेंस, टोबैको बडवॉर्म, आर्मी वॉर्म, बीटल्स, फ्लाइज एंड मॉस्किटोज कम्स इन टू डायप्टेरेंस. सो दीज आर द काइंड ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स. Now there is a, the what is the story, you can learn this in the form of a story. There is a bacterium, Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria. It is a gram-positive soil-dwelling bacteria and it produces a protein which is a protoxin. And in this bacteria, this protein exists in an inactive form. Okay, listen carefully. In these bacteria, this protein, these are the crystal protein. And these have the capacity to kill certain insects. Okay, so these protein act against these insects, all these insects. So this protein is present in the form of a protoxin, which is an inactive form of this, and it converts into the active form into a alkaline pH, a high pH, 8 to 10 generally. So what scientists have done, they have isolated the gene which has the resistance against these insect, or which is coding for the protein, and the gene is cryzine. And this cry, please notice this, this cry is written in italics. For italics I am underlying double. And for protein, the C is capital and CRY is in small. Okay, so difference in protein and gene is this, this gene is cryzine, and you will get written in this italics. And for protein, it is cry protein. This gene code for this protein, which is a crystal protein. Okay guys, so what they have done to make a BT cotton, they have isolated, the scientists have isolated this gene, which is BT gene. Okay, cryzine, from the Bacillus thuringiensis, and inserted into the crop, cotton crop. Now the transgenic crop is prepared. So whenever the insect come and it digest the part of the or the leaves, this inactive protein will be activate in a alkaline pH, which is present in the gut of the insect. And when it comes into active form, it will be die. Okay, is this clear? Is the principle is clear? Everyone, I am asking to everyone in the class, and I need a response. Show me a ratham, everyone. Kavya, Shri Harimurti, Shivani, Tasneem, Shri Vatsan, Manish, Sriyalakshmi, Mirza Sania, and Arvind, and also Anandita. So is this clear? What is BT cotton? So this is, by this means, they have prepared BT cotton, which is a genetically modified crop having a resistance against particular type of insect, because that BT cotton has the gene which produces a protoxin. And in why it is inactive in bacterium, why it is not degrading bacterium, because in bacterium this gene is present in the inactive form. So whenever the pest will come and digest the crop. It will go to the gut of the insect, and in the gut of the insect, it will bind to the epithelium surface, and there will be lysis, and the whole insect will die. So by this mean, it is providing the resistance. I am asking to others also. So here is the content about the same. BT toxin is biological. You have to remember this in this form of story, but you have to learn these things. There are 5 things you have to learn about BT cotton. First of all, BT is biologically produced by the bacterium. The name of the bacterium, that is in examination, you will have 5 things. And you have to remember all the 5 things, because when the question will come from this chapter, one question either or two question depends sometimes. So in the options, in the 4 options, might be this is not asking the direct question BT cotton, but you will have like which of the following statement is true. So for the following statement to answer, to attempt the question, you need to remember each and everything which is written here. So the name of the bacterium, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, that is BT. The question was like, BT stands for what? It is not for biotechnology. BT doesn't stand for biotechnology. The BT in AMC, it was asked. So BT is for Bacillus thuringiensis, and BT cotton is a genetically modified crop, and this bacterium, it produces insecticidal protein, that is the cry protein. So you can see here the C is capital. Okay, which is a protoxin produced in bacteria during a particular phase of growth. BT toxin is encoded by the gene CRY genes. So you have to remember the name of the genes also. CRY1AC is there, as it is you have to remember. CRY2AB is there, CRY1AB is there, CRY2AC is there. Now this BT toxin genes are isolated from the bacteria and incorporated into several crop plants like cotton, which has Lepidopteran insect as pest. Okay guys, so Bacillus thuringiensis is BT gram positive soil dying bacteria. It releases BT toxin. Its gene is isolated from this bacterium and introduced in the plants like cotton, and they have make a what? BT cotton is prepared. Genetically modified cotton is ready now. And it gives resistance to plant from the insects. So in plant, this gene is in inactive form. When we are inserting this gene is in inactive form. In insect gut, when the insect come and digest the part of the plant, it changes into active form, because the active form is only in presence of a alkaline pH. And in the gut of the insect, this alkaline pH is maintained. Now the activated toxin now binds to the midgut surface of epithelial cells, and swelling and lysis occurs later on, and which causes the death of the insect. So there is no harm of the crop. So this is how RDNA technology and how a transgenic plant is has a enhanced values, like this BT cotton. If the plant is not going to have any harm, the productivity will be already increased. The productivity level will be increased level. Okay, so this is all about the BT cotton. So you have to remember the name of the bacterium, protoxin. Now the choice of the gene depends on the targeted crop and insect species. At most BT toxin are insect group specific, because these genes very very important. I am saying again, it should be on tips, because in examination they are not going to ask how they have prepared a transgenic plant. They will ask about the genes CRY, like this is in italics, CRY1AC and CRY2AB is cotton. It control cotton boll worm specifically. BT toxins are insect group specifically. cry 1AB and cry 2AC. It is control cotton corn borer worm. Okay. So learn is as it is. If you have understand the topic, there is like you can easily learn the topic. First, the understanding of the topic is very, very important so that you can retain the whole concept in your mind. After you understand the process, there is the need to learn the facts. Like you have to remember this, you have to learn this. I am saying again. Okay, understanding the concept is very much needed. Without understanding any concept, you cannot retain it. You cannot answer the logical questions. And when you understand the topic, the learning is very, very easy. Okay, guys? Now the second example, how genetic engineering is useful for a plant, increase in photosynthetic yield. You must have known about a enzyme that is Rubisco. Where we have learned about Rubisco? Genetic manipulation in Rubisco. Rubisco is what? Ribulose 1,5-bi phosphate. And it is a very important enzyme of photosynthesis. Okay, in Ralph reaction. When the fixation of CO2 is done, then there is the need of Rubisco. Okay? So what is the quality of the Rubisco? Who is going to write? It has an additional feature. Not only with carboxylation or the fixing of the carbon, CO2 to get the substrate, to get the carbohydrate, it also has oxygenase properties. If you recall the process of photosynthesis, there are two steps. One is the light reaction, second one is the dark reaction. So in the dark reaction, there is the use of the assimilatory power which is generated, and there is the use of the Rubisco. So Rubisco act as a carboxylase as well as oxygenase. It has both carboxylase property as well as oxygenase. So most of the time it act as a carboxylase. It act for the fixation of CO2. But when it act for oxygenation, that it decreases the photosynthetic yield. Okay, so what scientists have done, they have genetically modified Rubisco, and by means of genetic alteration in Rubisco gene, they inhibit its oxygenase activity. So now the new Rubisco enzyme has all the carboxylation properties. It will not work as an oxygenase enzyme. So once a gene controlling Rubisco enzyme has been transferred from pea plant to tobacco plant, very, very important. Already question has been asked. Rubisco having both carboxylase as well as oxygenase property. So it, when it works as oxygenase enzyme, it reduces the yield of photosynthesis. So what scientists have done, they have done alteration in the gene of Rubisco so that it should not behave as an oxygenase enzyme. So it increases the photosynthetic yield. And one such experiment has been done in pea plant to tobacco plant. Once a gene controlling Rubisco enzyme has been transferred from the pea plant to tobacco plant, so you have to remember the name of the pea to tobacco, to increase photosynthetic process and crop yield. Okay, so this is the another example. Third one, very, very important again. Tomato plant flower cell. It is a genetically modified tomato plant which produces much less cell wall degrading enzyme. The name of the enzyme is polygalactouronase, which is responsible for fruit ripening. So So in this type of tomato plant, this variety you have to remember as it is tomato plant. Flapsar is a genetically modified tomato plant which produces very less cell wall degrading enzyme. Name of the enzyme you have to remember again and again, polygalactouronase. And this polygalactouronase is responsible for fruit ripening. When there will be less polygalactouronase enzyme, then we can increase the larger, we can have a larger and favorable shelf life. Okay, so questions has been asked on this, what is the quality of these tomatoes, have favorable and large shelf life. So you can see here various type of qualities which are needed for a crop, for those different kind of gene has been introduced in a particular type of crop or a plant, so that there can be better quality plant in terms of nutritional value, in terms of any other, like which favors the shelf life, so it delayed the food ripening. Okay, and the name of the enzyme is polygalactouronase. So these examples are very 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 important. We cannot say the question will be from BT cotton, the question will be from tomato plant, or the question will be from golden rice. But when the question is like pick the correct option, guys, so you have to be prepared for all these kind of questions. Match the column. For match the column, if there is like tomato plant flapsar and here given polygalactouronase, so you have to remember each and everything about any of the example which I am giving here. Okay guys, is this clear? Is this clear, everyone in the class? This is a very interesting topic, guys. Tomorrow we will be have very interesting story kind of thing about the RNAi technique, which is a very very interesting technique for nematodes protection, from the protection from nematodes. Is this clear? I am asking again. Transgenic genetically engineering plants can also produce pharmaceutically important compounds. These compounds such as human insulin, we will be talking tomorrow about this. Interferons also tomorrow in detail, because interferons, human insulins, question can be anywhere. All these topics are very very important. Synthesize antibody and vaccine in fruits, how these are important. Bear flowers with new colors and long life for better ornamental purposes. So what are all these? All these are the applications of biotechnology. So here see the example for better ornamental purposes. So this is how the biotechnology is useful. It produces pharmaceutically important compounds such as human insulin, interferons, hormones. Synthesize antibody and vaccines in fruit, bear flowers with new colors and long life for better ornamental purpose. I am giving you a homework here today. What we are doing at home after the class or whenever you get time before tomorrow's session, you have to line by line read NCERT first 2 pages of this chapter. Line by line you have to read out. It will take like half an hour you have to give to read line by line NCERT, because most of the questions are coming from the complicated language of the NCERT. So each and every line is important. I am giving emphasis on NCERT because 90% questions are coming from there, and for that, for attempting all the question in a very very good way, you should be useful to the language or the terminology of the question. Okay guys, everyone, so you have to, for today's homework, you have to learn 2 pages, like reading you can do in 20 minutes or hardly in 30 minutes. Have a good recap at home of NCERT line by line. Take a pencil, read line and line and see how beneficial it is. You will, while attempting any mock test or any test series, you will see what is the benefit of reading the NCERT line by line. You have understood the whole topic here. Now what is your homework, what you have to do, a little hard work also, whatever chapter you have completed. And this is also for chemistry and physics. For chemistry, very much needed. Now here comes the session for the illustration. I hope all the topics from today's session is clear with you. Everyone, I am asking to everyone, if you have any query, go to home, have a revision, you can ask tomorrow also. Before the session, if you have any query, you can write in the chat box, I will reply, or in comment section also you can write, guys, so that we can save also time. If you have any query, write in the comment section below the video, I will give you a reply there also, so we can also save the time and we can have many questions. But the reading for NCERT for every chapter is must for all of you. Okay, which one of the following option is correct? The protein encoded by the genes Cry1AC and Cry2AB control cotton ball worms. Like, this is the question from last 10-year examinations. Protein encoded by Cry1AB controls corn borer. So what is the answer here? I am waiting for the answer. This is a direct question. You have to learn these things. I have written important, very, very important. So the answer, it is third, protein encoded by Cry1AB controls corn borer. And it is like 1AC, 2AB. 1AB and 2AC. The combination is like this. You can learn by means of a trick also. BT toxin kill the larvae of certain insects. BT toxin kill the larvae of certain insects. Like this is a repetition. By binding of activated toxin on midgut epithelial cell, creating pores leading to swelling and lysis. By stopping transcription of larval cell. By altering central dogma taking place in the cells of gut of larva. By stopping protein synthesis. So what should be the answer for the question number 2? Write like this, to this. BT toxin kills the larvae of certain insects, BT, by binding. What is the action? How the BT toxin works? Just we have gone through the procedure. What it does? When the insect came, it bind to the midgut epithelial cell and it creates the pores, and by means of the pores it creates the swelling of the cell and ultimately lysis and the killing of the insect. So the answer here is A. Everyone has given the right answer. For these kind of questions, like, you have to learn like the Cry genes, okay, and the examples of the plant. So many examples will come tomorrow and ready for that when we will talk about the example of transgenic plants and the qualities in them. So you will have a lot of examples there in tomorrow's session and day after tomorrow's episode. For those, you have to learn. Understood the topic completely, summarize the whole thing in your mind and learn. The trigger of activation of toxin of Bacillus thuringiensis is so many questions from a simple processor. Sometimes they ask about the act, sometimes they act about the why it is inactive in this. Third, answer for the question number third. Answer the question number. This is a direct question, but I have taken to make it clear for you. Very nice. Very nice, Sri Hari Murthy, Sri R. Lakshmi, Shivani Rajesh, and Kavya. This is the alkaline pH of the gut, which changes the protoxin into the active form. So here comes the question, like, which is not a transgenic plant? Which is not a transgenic plant? Soyabean, maize, golden rice, cucumber. I have given the same example, I think. The choices were different. I have given like petunia. Tomorrow we will be having assertion and reasoning, because there is very very interesting topic, RNAi and insulin also. Question number 4, the answer for the question number 4. One response has come, what about the others? Everyone should give the answer. If you have any query, you can write in comment section also. I will reply for sure. And so that we can save also time. And also if you have, just go for the revision. If any doubt, you can ask me tomorrow. Yes, for the question number 4, the answer is cucumber. Cucumber is not a transgenic plant. Soyabean, maize, golden rice also already have developed. I'm sorry. Transgenic animals are produced for the to study how genes are regulated and how they affect the normal functions of body and its development, to study of diseases, to obtaining useful biological products, to test of vaccine safety and chemical safety. So what is the use of transgenic animals? I will be discussing about different, like transgenic cow, buffaloes, pig, all these things in session 3. But here comes the question, a general question, why the transgenic plants and animals, like. So answer this question, question number 5. Transgenic animals are produced for the to study how genes are regulated, for the regulation of the gene, how they affect the normal functions of body and its development, and to study of diseases, to obtaining useful biological products, to test of vaccine safety and chemical safety. Is it not for using to get, okay, 5A, yes, you have written in this form only. Tasneem and Shivani has given the answer. What about the others? I am waiting for the response for the other students. Read the statement carefully, always. Yes, these are produced transgenic animals. These are used to study for the gene regulation, their effect on the body, also for the study of diseases, to get the useful biological products, to test vaccine safety and chemical safety also. So the answer is A here, and everyone has given the right answer. Which of the following is a correct statement? Which of the following is a correct statement? BT in BT cotton indicates that it is genetically modified organism produced through biotechnology. Somatic hybridization involves fusion of two complete plants and carrying desired gene. The anticoagulant hirudin is being produced from transgenic brassica napa seeds. Flexer variety of tomato has enriched the production of ethylene, which improves its taste. Now, I want everyone to answer the last question. What should be the answer for this question? BT in BT cotton indicates that it is genetically modified organism. No, just we have gone through. Somatic hybridization, it involves fusion of protoplast. Somatic hybridization, it involves fusion of two complete plant cell carrying desired gene in protoplast fusion. The anticoagulant hirudin is being produced from transgenic brassica napa seed. Flexer variety of tomato has enriched the production of ethylene. No. So what should be the answer? How you can assure that it has the desired gene? When we are involving the whole genome, we are not sure about this. May or may not situation can be there. Give me the reason why 6B. Reason. In somatic hybridization, the answer is C here. Actually, I am giving you the whole detail of this tomorrow. It is included in tomorrow's session. But as the question has these things, so I have taken. Here it is the delayed production of ethylene. We will be discussing about this. But this anticoagulant hirudin is being produced from the transgenic brassica napa seeds. And this is one of the most important application of biotechnology. So answer here is C. Okay, it doesn't indicate for biotechnologically genetically modified organism Bacillus thuringiensis, and we are not assured that it is carrying our desired gene. May or may not be. For the desired gene, we are just using our DNA technology. So that is the difference. Flavicer, because it decrease the ethylene production because the shelfing life has been increased. Okay, so the answer for this is C. So I hope this session is very much useful for all of you. Have a complete revision at home. Do hard work, manage your time, give time to each and every subject, and the homework is that you have to learn line by line reading of the NCRT, which is very, very important. Also do the reading for biotechnology, sexual reproduction and other chapter which you have completed or you are sure like you have gone through those chapters of chemistry also. I am also saying chemistry. NCRT reading is very, very important. Again, I am giving emphasis on NCRT reading because generally students avoid or they escape some points from NCRT, but the question comes from there only. So we are meeting tomorrow. Do hard work, you will get success for sure. There is no shortcut. You have to learn, read in a very, like on a daily basis. ओके, थैंक यू सो मच गाइस, हैप्पी लर्निंग, हैव ए नाइस डे, ओके, बाय बाय.